I declare this congregation for the conferment of degrees open, and I call upon the Chairman of the Council of Queen Mary, Sir Christopher France.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and a warm welcome to this degree ceremony. I hope that the welcome from all of us here on this platform will help you to feel that your journey here today was well worthwhile in making you part of what is, for everyone here, a very special day. There are different ways in which it will be special for the various people who are in this hall, but for many of us it marks a milestone. And that is true of the college as a whole, as well as of individuals in it. What is the college? The last century saw the development and coalescence of the four institutions that provide the firm foundations of the major college of the University of London, that is Queen Mary and Westfield, with its medical and dental school. We're grateful for what's been done by our predecessors and ready to make even more of their legacy in the years ahead. Today's graduands are very much part of that process because they've drawn on the legacy and themselves add to what the college, of which they form an important part, has achieved. I hope that after this afternoon's ceremony, you'll have an opportunity to see something of the campus and meet some of the people who make up the wide span of this college. From the wide range of disciplines represented in it, we shall this afternoon be welcoming people from the School of Medicine and Dentistry, from the Faculty of Engineering and Mathematical Sciences, and from the Faculty of Natural Sciences. For each of the graduands here, to whom I extend my warm congratulations, today marks a personal milestone. You can certainly look back on a time of achievement here at the college, and I hope you'll do so with pleasure and satisfaction. But you can look forward, too, to a life in which you'll be able to develop the opportunities and carry the responsibilities which your new status will confer. We're also delighted to have with us today so many members of families and friends to help make this a really special occasion. Your presence and the support you offer the graduands add something that none of the rest of us can offer. A moment ago, I spoke about the personal aspect of this afternoon's ceremony. There are a lot of graduands here, and shortly we shall invite you to come to this platform and have your degrees conferred upon you. Though for each of you this focus of the ceremony is brief, it is a vital step in the acquisition of your new status, which makes it happen for you. So I hope that each one of the graduands will feel that, for a moment, the process is very personal, for you're not graduating en masse, but as individuals. And I hope that all our guests who've come to support the graduands will feel the same sense of focus as they see their own candidate come to the platform. This procedure is necessarily rather formal. It is bound to be so because it's no light matter to confer, or have conferred upon one, a degree of the University of London. I hope that the formality will not dim the sense of pleasure we all feel, but rather accent the sense of achievement, to which so many here today are very properly entitled. As I have said, a degree ceremony marks an important turning point. We look forward to the future, but we also recognize that there is an inevitable break with the life we have lived at Queen Mary. However, even in this ending, there are opportunities for new relationships. And so I hope that those of you who will move on, having graduated today, will feel that you want to keep in touch with us and with the friends you've made here. We shall certainly be delighted if you do, and there is a vigorous alumni association that will help you to retain those links. Now, it only remains for me to wish the graduands the very best of luck in the years ahead, and increasing satisfaction and success with whatever path you choose as you pass today's milestone.
Sir Christopher, ladies and gentlemen, as the principal of Queen Mary, I'd like first to echo most warmly Sir Christopher's welcome to you all. Today is an important occasion. It's obviously a very special day for those of you graduating. It celebrates your academic achievements and marks the end of a very special period of your life. But this is an important day, too, for your family and friends, who will have shared in the efforts and sacrifices that you have made over the past few years. They can now share also in the pleasure of your success, and I, too, extend a warm welcome to all families and friends here today. The degree you will receive on this occasion is a special one. First and foremost, it is a degree of the University of London, and as such, will be recognized throughout the world as certifying that you have graduated from a top international university. Universities are important institutions. They underpin the intellectual, professional, and cultural life of this country, and they play a fundamental role in the UK economy. Our universities generate annually over £35 billion of output and sustain over 500,000 full-time equivalent jobs. And for every 100 jobs provided within universities, a further 90 are generated through knock-on effects on the economy. And for every £1 million of economic output from universities, a further £1.5 million is generated in other sectors of the economy. And within this vitally important higher education sector, London plays a special role. It is not only the academic capital of the UK, but can rightly be regarded as the academic capital of Europe. London educates approximately 340,000 students each year, and London's universities produce one-third of all the UK's research academic output. And London attracts twice as many students from outside the UK as any other UK region, over 60,000 international students currently studying in London. And within the higher education sector of London, the University of London itself stands as the oldest and most celebrated of our universities and one of the great universities of the world. Queen Mary is the third largest of the multi-faculty institutions in the University of London, now with over 10,000 students and nearly 1,000 academic staff. The degree to which graduands will be admitted today records that each of them has been a student at this famous university and has emerged successfully from the academic process. So to those of you graduating, whatever strains and stresses you've had to endure to make it to this point today, the University of London degree to which you will be admitted shortly as graduates of Queen Mary will make it all worthwhile. You're looking very unconvinced by that, so let's say, tell me to stop you worrying about your overdraft and just keep remembering that over the course of a lifetime, graduates on average amass 40% more income than non-graduates. Today, the UK university sector is incredibly diverse. 25 years ago, those who can remember that far back, there were some 50-odd universities with just 6%, one in 16 or 17 of the population, going on to higher education. Now we have over 180 degree-awarding institutions and over 35% of the age cohort going on to higher education, a rate which the government is committed to increasing to 50% over the coming decade. So not unnaturally, within this very diverse UK higher education sector, the nature, flavour, profile and image of each institution is very different. And Queen Mary has a rather special character of its own. First, it's a research-led university whose academic staff are known and respected nationally and internationally as experts in their fields and as leading researchers, teachers, and professional practitioners. We are in the top 20 English universities in terms of the volume of research we undertake. This year, our research income at Queen Mary from bids in competition with other universities is up by 20% over what it was just 2 years ago. This year we've been awarded a further £12.5 million to invest in science research infrastructure, most of which will be spent in those areas represented by this afternoon's graduands. Our international character is also reflected in our student population. It's an astonishing fact that we currently have students here now from over 100 different countries, giving us one of the UK's most vibrant student communities and enhancing the learning and social experience of all our students. But in terms of the character of the institution, at the same time as aspiring to the highest levels of national and international excellence in teaching and research, the college has never lost sight of its particular location in the city in the East End of London, the needs of the local community, and the responsibility of the institution and of those who work and study in it to contribute to that community, both academically and socially. And in this respect, let me pay tribute to the students of Queen Mary and to the commitment of our Students' Union for their outstanding voluntary contributions to supporting the local community, in particular through their work with children and the elderly. The university world is living through challenging times, not least financially, and you will have all seen in the news how it's been dominated recently by discussions of so-called top-up fees. Despite all that, we at Queen Mary are very optimistic about our future. New courses are being developed and offered to meet changing patterns of student demand, and we have a number of exciting building projects underway. In Whitechapel, a new state-of-the-art medical school building has recently featured in the press as one of the six most exciting building projects in London. And here at Mile End, over by the canal, we are building a whole new student village, which will provide nearly 1,000 additional living units, the first of which we hope will be ready for occupation in January. So in addition to all our academic attractions, this will make Queen Mary the only truly campus university within easy reach of central London, and again, we hope, give us an even greater edge over our competitors. Those of you about to receive your degrees already know that this is a special place. We shall ensure that it remains so for coming generations of students. This afternoon, we are conferring degrees on graduands from Barts and the London, Queen Mary's School of Medicine and Dentistry, from the Faculty of Engineering and Mathematical Sciences, and the Faculty of Natural Sciences. I remarked earlier how important this day is for all the graduands and their families. The day is important, too, for those of us at Queen Mary who have shared with you your time at the college. We, of course, take pleasure in your achievements, but we are also bidding you farewell, and we shall miss you. Some of you, anyway. We shall shortly admit you to your degrees, but I want to stress to you, as Sir Christopher did, that your connection with the college does not end at this point. You remain a member, and I urge you to keep in contact. The College Alumni Relations Office will ensure that graduates are all kept fully informed of the activities of the association and will provide a link which makes sure you can continue to be in touch with us and, equally important, with each other. On behalf of all of us at Queen Mary, to the graduands, I wish you all the very best for the future. We now come to the conferment of degrees. I call upon Professor Nick Wright, Warden of the School of Medicine and Dentistry, to present graduands from the school.
Principal, I call upon the Deputy Warden, Professor Peter Copeman, to assist in the presentation of candidates. For the degrees of Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery, Derek Hon Tung Chan. Majed Hussein. Ian Porter. Sang Jun Tong. William James Tui. Dennis Peter John Woodhouse. Principal, I call upon the Director of the Institute of Dental Surgery, Professor Paul Wright, to assist in the presentation of candidates from the dental school. For the degree of Bachelor of Dental Surgery, Hardip Singh Dutt. Davinder Singh Mali. Robin Ratcliffe. Neil Thomas Scott, who's been awarded the Evelyn Sprawson Prize. Kyeth Shubba. Alok Yashwant Shukla. Alex Tahani. That concludes the conferment of Bachelor of Dental Surgery degrees. For the postgraduate diploma in occupational therapy, Debbie Jo Atkins. Christine Marie Balfe. Sally Jane Beestel. Ellen Lucy Campbell. Natalie Hannah Kate Cole. Rosalind Geraldine Curtis. Denise Leslie Dickinson. Ali May Elasidi. Jula Grantham. Louise Marie Joanne Hill. Caris Elizabeth James. Karen Lee Johnson. Samantha Louise Jones. Gulshana Kadir. Anne Taylor Key. Rabia Khatun. Falguni Janendra Kothari. Elizabeth Harriet Lands. Emma Louise Matthews. Gail Caroline Macrina. Kenrick Hugh Arthur Morgan. Sean Dermot Nugent. Claire Louise Ollendorf. Tricia Anne-Marie Payton. Ruth Kristen Perrett. Nicola Arlette Ann Pick. Christina Ruth Popplestone. Ruth Claire Pradden. Elizabeth Jane Ray. Louisa Jane Robinson. Robert Toby Schneider. Suzanne Louise Stubbs. Jana Zamiknikova. Principal, I call upon the Director of the Institute of Dental Surgery, Professor Paul Wright, to assist in the presentation of candidates from the dental school. For the degree of Master of Clinical Dentistry, Catherine Victoria Amatham. Lama Elsaig Brown, who's been awarded the degree with distinction. Maria Piana, who has been awarded the degree with distinction. Rosemary Watling, who's been awarded the degree with distinction and the Draper's Company Prize. Nigel Stuart Wilmot, who's been awarded the degree with distinction. That concludes the conferment of Master of Clinical Dentistry degrees. For the degree of Master of Science, Adnan Ahmad. Sani Hussein Aliyu, who's been awarded the degree with distinction and the Draper's Company Prize. Meher Amazri. Catherine Letitia Atkins. Shabana Azam. Rosa Bonato. Leah Biller. C. Cyril Barry Brazil. Sadia Bashir Chugtai. Claire Harris. Dahlia Zed Ibrahim Hassan. Anna Marija Yorga. Easter Jury, who's been awarded the degree with distinction. Huma Naz Khan. Khalid Mahmoud Khattab. Louise Letley. Iona Michaeline Lowe. Peter Kuri Geo Manthali. Ali Sanoza Omrani. Colin William Perkins. Alison Ruth Margaret Ray, who's been awarded the degree with distinction. Mohammed Rizwan. Sayed Abbas Raza Shah. Abdul Majed Sheikh. Rob Shorten. Nancy Khalil Tamimi. For the degree of Master of Research, Claudia Avalone. Lola Fakharidi. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Developing a DNA Vaccine against Francella Tularensis and the supervision of Dr. Keith Nye and Mrs. Jennifer Slaney, Mariam Bakit Al-Shamizi. For a thesis entitled The Role of Endothelial Function and Oxidant Stress in the Model of Insulin Resistance, under the supervision of Dr. Martin Carrier, Tara Jane Andrews. For a thesis entitled the use of molecularly imprinted polymers in pharmaceutical analysis under the supervision of Professor David Perrett, Matthew Paul Davis. For a thesis entitled Structure and Function Relationships of Mutation in Human Melanocortin Receptors 1 and 2, under the supervision of Dr. Supriya Kapas, Marina Dufexis. For a thesis entitled Characterization of Urinary Stones Using Low-Angle X-ray Scattering, under the supervision of Dr. Julie Horrocks, Ruby Yi Lo Fong. For a thesis entitled Physical Properties of Novel Dental Composite Polymeric Systems, under the supervision of Dr. Richard Clark, Nina Elizabeth Howe. For a thesis entitled Cardiac Capillary Morphology and Its Relationship to Oxidative Stress and Lipid Peroxidation in Ischemia and Reperfusion, under the supervision of Dr. Barbara Ward, Catherine Ann Molyneux. For a thesis entitled The Development of a Dual Wavelength Spectrophotometry System and Its Application in the Study of Free Flap Viability in Plastic and Reconstructive Surgery, under the supervision of Dr. Derek Jones, John Anthony Pickett. For a thesis entitled The Upper and Lower Airways in COPD, under the supervision of Professor Vishened Visha, Nicola Jane Roberts. For a thesis entitled Studied on the Role of CEPB beta and GAD153 in the regulation of keratin 6 and keratin 16 gene expression in the context of keratinocyte activation, under the supervision of Dr. Stephen Bustin, Dr. Ian Mackay, Professor Irene Lee, Professor Ray Isles, Elena Volianic. For a thesis entitled Megakaryocyte Endomitosis, the expression of glycoproteins 1b and 3a in megakaryocyte differentiation and their role in endomitosis in correlation with cell cycle proteins, under the supervision of Professor Adrian Lee and Dr. May Cahill, Claire Susan Wiggins. For the degree of Doctor of Medicine, for a thesis entitled Long-Term Morbidity in Survivors of a Randomized Controlled Trial of Extracorporeal Membrane Oxygenation within the United Kingdom, follow-up of 4 years of age, under the supervision of Dr. Anne Johnson and Professor Kate Costello, Charlotte Bennett. And that concludes the confirmative degrees from the School of Medicine and Dentistry.
I call upon the Academic Dean of the Faculty of Engineering and Mathematical Sciences to present the graduands from that faculty.
principal, I call upon Professor John Stark, head of the Department of Engineering, to assist in the presentation of candidates. For the degree of Bachelor of Engineering with Honours, Teslim Inamidim Adewale. Shan Xuan Chai. Marcus Christian Newton. Nikiforos Stavros Parcelidis. Napoleon Vavatsis. For the degree of Master of Science, Nicholas Adublu. C.Y. Bayo. Avin Kalkutia. Alikan Esmail, who has been awarded a degree with distinction. Kamran Shafkat, who's been awarded a degree with distinction. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Condensation Heat Transfer on Tube Banks with and without the presence of a non-condensing gas, under the supervision of Dr. Adrian Briggs, Han Hai Bui. For a degree of Master of Engineering with Honours, Shehzad Akhtar, who's been awarded first class honours. And that concludes the conferment of degrees from the Department of Engineering. Principal, I call upon Professor Paul Hogg, head of the Department of Materials, to assist in the presentation of candidates. For the degree of Master of Engineering with Honours, Lin Ding. Zhai Bing Liu. Dazzy Wang. Huey Wang, who's been awarded first class honours. Tong Wang. Weiina Yang. Yan Ping Yi. Bin Zhao. Fu Yo Zhu, who's been awarded first class honours. For the degree of Master of Science, Kathrik Balasubramanian. Yeah. Gautam Bhattacharya, who's been awarded a degree with distinction and the Draper's Company Prize. Vibhish Jimmy Gunaratnam. F.M. Umut Kok. Ruth Sharples. Chao Zong Wu. Jun Lin Yin. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy for a thesis entitled An Investigation into the Mechanical and Biological Properties of Acrylic Bone Cement Containing Triphenyl Bimethyl as an Alternative Radio Pacifier under the supervision of Dr. John Bahiri, Saba Abdulghani. For a degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Experimental Investigation and Molecular Dynamic Simulation of Binder Removal in Powder Compacts, under the supervision of Professor Zai Guo, Caroline Siu Yoke Ji. For a degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Mechanochemical Synthesis of Magnesium-Based Hydrogen Storage Materials under the supervision of Professor Zhao Guo, Kong Zhao Shang. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Feasibility Study of the Vacuum Infusion of Composite Infield Repairs, under the supervision of Professor Paul Hogg, Demetrius Tsetsetsis. And that concludes the conferment of degrees from the Department of Materials. Principal, I call upon Professor Laurie Cuthbert, head of the Department of Electronic Engineering, to assist in the presentation of candidates. For the degree of Bachelor of Engineering with Honours, Tan Chi Nguyen. For the degree of Master of Science, Amir Aryanpour. Nuno Daniel da Silva Cardoso, who's been awarded a degree with distinction. Lu Dai. Xining Deng. Miliana Feynman. Justin Wan Siu Fung. Shehzad Gilani. Jason Kunkar. Y. Ming Kwok. Seung Min Lee. Wensei Lee. Zio Zio Lee. Yu Hin Eugene Ling. Kai Yin Liu. Rupert Ogilvie, who's been awarded a degree with distinction and the IEEE UK and Republic of Ireland Communications Chapter MSc Prize. Oyubela Olugbenga Opanayi. Durathai Palakun. Zen Chin, who's been awarded a degree with distinction. Jithendriya Yagavandan. Han Don Ran. Muhammad Fazan Tahir. Ketki Temgutnikar. Massimiliano Tonelli, who's been awarded a degree with distinction. Fernando Manuel Valente Ramos, who's been awarded a degree with distinction and the Draper's Company Prize. Dan Dan Wu. Yan Min Z, who's been awarded a degree with distinction. Anand Yagnik. Xinghui Yang. Na Yao, who's been awarded a degree with distinction and the Draper's Company Prize. Lin Zhang. Bo Zhu. For a degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Self-Organizing Algorithms for Fourth Generation Wireless Networks and Its Analysis Using Complexity Metrics, under the supervision of Professor Jonathan Pitts, Lester Say Wee Ho. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Radio Resource Management for Improving the Quality of Service of Cellular Code Division Multiple Access Networks, under the supervision of Dr. John Bigham, Y. Sum Tong. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Finite Difference Time Domain Simulation and Measurement of Millimeter Wave Receivers, under the supervision of Dr. Mark Rayner, Su B. Yap. and that concludes the conferment of degrees from the Department of Electronic Engineering. Principal, I now call upon Professor Edmund Robinson, head of the Department of Computer Science, to also assist in the presentation of candidates for the joint programme between Computer Science and Electronic Engineering. For the degree of Master of Science, Daniel Ahrens. Biju Apukutan. Matthew Bolton, who's been awarded a degree with distinction. Emanuele Vincenzo Campaniello. Marios Christofi. Shonkori Datta. Diana Evans. Jason Flowers, who has been awarded a degree with distinction. Hiran Mahesh Gunasekera. Abdul Hakim. Wajahat Halim. Shorda Katun. Liang Liang, who has been awarded a degree with distinction. Gokulan Manikathasaga. Priya Patel, who's been awarded a degree with distinction. Amer Saeed. Syed Mohammed Shakil. Pengzi Song. Raymond Tan, who has been awarded a degree with distinction. Zan Tang. Frank James Wasowski, who's been awarded a degree with distinction. Zia Zhao. Yan Zhu. That completes the presentation of graduands from the joint program between the Department of Electronic Engineering and the Department of Computer Science. Principal, I call upon Professor David Arrowsmith, head of the School of Mathematical Sciences, to assist in the presentation of candidates. For degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Ezra Kaza Ahmed. Andrew Peter Leary. Eliani, for the degree of Master of Science, Eliani Susan Beckford. Peter William Dargu, who's been awarded a degree with distinction and a Greatest Company Prize. Suzanne Jane Elliott. Susan Linda MacDonald. Sheena Rajnikant Patel. Elizabeth Jacqueline Platt. Richard Mark Severs. And that concludes the conferment of degrees from the School of Mathematical Sciences. Principal, I call upon Professor Edmund Robinson, Head of the Department of Computer Science, to assist in the presentation of candidates. For degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Animal Khan. Jonathan Levy. Michael Cappy Akello, who has been awarded first class honours. Amardeep Sharma. Kugaraj Sivasundaram. Farhan Ali Syed, who's been awarded first class honours and the Westfield Trust Prize. For the degree of Master of Science, Manjeet Baj, who's been awarded a degree with distinction. Anna Chamakioti. Tat Ming Chow. Mian Guan Lim. Kovinda Singh Sagu. Muhammad Abbas Shamsi. Peter James Woodward. And that concludes the conferment of degrees from the Department of Computer Science and from the Faculty of Engineering and Mathematical Sciences.
I call upon the Academic Dean of the Faculty of Natural Sciences to present graduands from that faculty.
Principal, I call upon Professor Peter Heathcote, Head of the School of Biological Sciences, to assist in the presentation of candidates. For the degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Angeliki Asimaki, who has been awarded the degree with First Class Honours and the Bevan Prize. Fayek Mia. Preena Patel. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy for a thesis entitled Plant-Associated Invertebrate and Periphyton Communities in Lakes, under the supervision of Dr. Ewan Jones and Professor Alan Hildrew, Angela Beresford. For a thesis entitled Alternative Male Mating Tactics in the Three-Spined Stickleback, Gasterosteus aculeatus, under the supervision of Dr. Chris Falks and Dr. Carl Smith, Stephen Clive Lacomba. For a thesis entitled Male Reproductive Success in the Beau Gregory Damselfly, Stegastes leucostictus, under the supervision of Dr. Andrew Campbell and Dr. Carl Smith, Adam Gordon Payne. And that concludes the conferment of degrees from the School of Biological Sciences. Principal, I call upon Professor Vaughan Griffiths, head of the Department of Chemistry, to assist in the presentation of candidates. For the degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Seema Barad. Joanna Bernadette Bruno. Zamia Kalik. Patricia Boadua Occhieri. Derek Ling Lung Poon. Tariq Masafa Qureshi. For the degree of Master of Science, Marzwa Abdelazim. Amalia Diakadu. Reshma Mandalia. Shakira Nawaz. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Design, Synthesis and Use of Inorganic Materials for Gas and Liquid and Gas Phase Catalysis, under the supervision of Professor Alice Sullivan, Stuart John Gardner. For a thesis entitled Probing the Mechanism of Enolate Pronation under the supervision of Dr. Jason Eames, Niluka Ashadi Wirasuraya. And that concludes the conferment of degrees from the Department of Chemistry. Principal, I call upon Professor David Dunstan, head of the Department of Physics, to assist in the presentation of candidates. For the degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours, Mandeep Singh Chana. This is the very last one. Yes. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, for a thesis entitled Comparative Effects of Solvation and Pressure on Liquids and Biological Molecules, under the supervision of Professor David Dunstan, Nancy Wilhelmina, Adriana Van Uden. And that concludes the conferment of degrees from the Department of Physics and from the Faculty of Natural Sciences.
Principal, I ask you to admit to their respective degrees those graduates who are unable to take their degrees in person.
I admit to their degrees in absentia those graduands so named. We have almost reached the end of the formal proceedings, but before we end, could I ask all families and friends to stand up and join my colleagues on the stage in standing up, please. And will you join us and turn towards these wonderful people and tell them what you think of them? Could I ask the graduates to stand as well? Here are your families and friends who've put up with you all this time. Why don't you tell them what you think of them? I declare this congregation for the conferment of degrees closed.